Madam President, His Highness, Director, distinguished guests, colleagues, friends, and family, it is an honor to share this day with you all, for this is an occasion of joy and pride. Today, we send off our undergraduate students who have spent formative years here. We welcome back our returning master's students who were here only too briefly. We recognize our diploma students, and we garland our research students who have toiled for their doctorates. A cornucopia of reasons drew us to this place. The world treasure that is our library, the ability to immerse ourselves in the regional and subject specialisms offered here, a burning desire to take up arms in the tradition of radical political activism in our community, an imagination moved by the creativity that powers our university. Coming from all different corners of the world, our paths converged here at SOAS. Graduates, you have persisted, led the way, embodied your own learning, and you are true fighters. Bursting with exuberance, this day is yours, but never were you alone. Journeying with the support and encouragement of those sitting right beside you, watching in other rooms, and those who could not be here today, but are always present. Let us take a moment now to mark the time and energy that those who have enabled us to learn have put in. Thank you to our teachers, advisors and mentors indeed for passing on so much knowledge and for sparking critical debates. Your work and the ways in which you practice it continue to inspire us. Thank you to all the staff who make this university tick. From the wonderful cleaners and security staff and members of Unison and UCU, you have looked out for us, mopped up our sick in the JCR, told us stories, got to know us, by all accounts raised us, whilst embroiled in fighting and winning your own struggles. You consistently engaged us in the wider campaign to preserve the integrity of our institution and our education. Thank you to our departmental and directorate staff, for whom we are grateful for stewarding us through our degrees with patience and devotion. Thank you as well to the unique characters of SOAS who serve us food, books, and of course, gossip. Last and foremost, a million times thank you to our parents, carers, and family above all, to our friends, lovers, partners. Forgive us for our impatience and disobedience and other faults, yet recognize how we have struggled. We love you and couldn't have done it without you. I was a graduate myself back in 2015 at a different university. There, I'd experienced the worlds of the classroom and the worlds of civic life to be distinctly separate. I did thrive in that environment too, doing theatre, opening my mind with critical theory and East Asian writings, and involving myself in organising for the Palestinian cause. But my friends and I hit ceilings left, right, and center, and felt continually frustrated. I first came to SOAS years ago, looking for Mahmoud Darwish in the library, and made more trips to attend a Decolonizing Our Minds student event and spoken word. I found then, and still find now, SOAS's public lectures so rich. If they do not go against the grain of much of the Eurocentric teachings many of us have been subjected to and subjects of at some stage, then their audiences would soon rectify that. With a high percentage of international and BAME staff and students as compared to home and white students, and given SOAS's colonial history, studying humanities at SOAS is pertinent and layered. As a working class British East Asian daughter of migrants from Hong Kong and Malaysia, SOAS has been invaluable to me for furthering my community work. Here we have the most active and smart student societies and organisers in the UK, so I believe that other SOASians also feel the same. It is no accident that many pioneers in our community have passed through these doors. This is not to fall into the trap of romanticising SOAS either. It has unfortunately become a refrain among students to say, bring back the A in School of Oriental and African Studies. Let us also renew our chance for dismantling the O in SOAS. This place is one where colonizing and colonized forces come together to do battle. Here we fight battles internal, calling the government and other universities and ourselves to account on the BME attainment gap, shifting the conversations on decolonizing, standing up to fascism and elected fascists on campus. These are microcosms of larger battles out there to be won. Foremost among our challenges ahead are concertedly tackling the climate emergency and redressing poverty and a world system which leaves people around the world in slavery, detention facilities, re-education camps, and forced labor. It is all too easy to turn away. But that is where self-care and care of your close ones is especially important, as well as appreciation and affirmation of each other's histories. Class of 2019, as you venture forward from these shores, you have more than anything a responsibility to shape this world into a better one. In a world with such unprecedented global challenges, we must rise to the occasion. So tell the stories that only you can tell, that the world needs to hear. Listen and be open, not set in your ways. Keep imagining and working towards goals that will benefit humanity. Stay true to yourself and your principles. Do not run away. Stand up again every time that you fall. To echo the poet Constantine Cavafy, remember how you were loved here. Know that you have contributed to enlargening not only SOAS's memory of the past and plans for the future, but humanity. I wish you all great things, that you will be happy and in global conversation with each other and the world. The world had better watch out. Thank you.